Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Stephen Lilly, who is the Chief Executive of Greencoat UK Wind. Stephen, great to have you back on. We spoke to you at the beginning of January, so 6 or 7 weeks ago. But since then, you have now published your final results for 2022. So perhaps you'd like to start by giving us the highlights.
Yeah, no, thank you. I think a month ago, we gave you some of the highlights, if you like, of the dividend increasing with RPI, the 13.4% from December's RPI, as we do every year. So that's the 10th time we've done that. So obviously that's a sort of key component. And then cash generation of 560 million, another sort of key sort of thought. And then what else? 11% capture of discount to power prices from last year. That gives you some sort of feeling for that. The capacity of the business and the commitments that we have coming forward in the next 6 months. So really, just I guess the audited process of the NAV announcement we had a few weeks ago. But the sort of key components of it, I guess, is the RPI linkage of the dividend is a key thing for us. And we've done that now 10 times to 6 pence in 2013. Has now become 8.76 pence, nearly 9 pence, in other words, by the time we get through to 10 years in. We've had a NAV that's increased from up to, you know, by 69% versus compounded RPI of 45. So that's obviously another key component to that. And then the other sort of 2 points, not just the RPI linkage of both the NAV and the dividend, is the sort of conservatism we've shown through the year and we still have in the business in terms of power prices. And then the return, that's another sort of thing that we've sort of been keen to sort of talk about. You know, as we get into a higher interest rate environment, the return we have in our business of 9% is, we think, highly attractive. It's delivered 9% yield and 4% growth. But I think sometimes that 4% growth is it's forgotten a little bit, but only this year when we've had lots of reinvestment, it's sort of kind of a bit more obvious. So that's one thing we're talking about.
So is that one of the things that you're most pleased with in these results, Stephen?
I think we've had a very simple model that we have exposed ourselves to the power price. That obviously last year has given us a lot of revenue coming in, and that's been good to do that. But most of that has been reinvested. So we had a dividend cover of 3.2 times, which means we've got 2.2 times of reinvestment. So the dividend we declared for the year was nearly £180 million. So 2.2 times of that is a lot of reinvestment that we've done that, and that's gone into, you know, our share of Hornsea One. It's gone to 20 shilling and some of the investment in the Kitemere extension, which comes online later in the year. So that reinvestment is a key part of our story. And just and through last year, that's a lot of what we've done, which is that reinvestment story. And, you know, growing a business that now produces about 1.6% of UK electricity. So it's a sizable business, on the verge, hopefully, of the FTSE 100 at some point. Not that particularly means anything. It's just slightly arbitrary, isn't it? But you know, the point being, I guess, is that we are an important part of the energy mix, a lot of our story is a very simple dividend that always increases with RPI. Always done that. Always will. And therefore, any excess is straight back into growing the business and helping the energy transition as a consequence.
It certainly sounds like you've been making hay while the sun's been shining there, Stephen. So when do you think that reinvestment is going to start paying off in terms of growth?
Well, so I mean, it already is in the sense that, you know, our gross assets have grown from about 4 billion to 5.5 last year. So a huge amount of growth there. Obviously that then starts to generate more cash and it, you know, we have a lot more investment going on. So I think it always does that. We see a market where, you know, there's a lot of need for recycling of capital. And it's, someone said to us, is that just because COVID has been released, if you like? And that's not the right expression, but, the COVID effect is finished, if you like, and therefore what might have been pent up is now coming through. And I think it's probably not the case. The thing that's more relevant, I guess, is that as we get the build out towards 2030 and the 50 gigawatts that the government wants, there's a lot of recycling that needs to happen. And we set our business up 10 years ago to be almost the prime recycler, the creation of a secondary market. And by creating a secondary market, a lot of capital has come into the sector, not just the $5.5 billion of gross assets that we have and the £5 billion of investment that we've done effectively over the last 10 years, but also all the other business, all the other peers coming into sort of a wider sector, and then a lot of the pension fund money coming into this. And this is all about getting additional capital into the sector, into a sector that's required. So we did that 10 years ago. We sort of increasingly see the need for that to happen as well. And so we see a pretty active market going forward because there's just a need. If you're going to get 50 gigawatts built, every source of capital possible is going to be required for that. And so we feel really well placed for that.
Understood. Well, just one final question from me, Stephen. The impression that I'm getting from you is that it's an incredibly solid enterprise that you've built here. But is there anything that's giving you any cause for concern at the moment? Any dark clouds on the horizon you might like to tell us about?
Not really. I mean, it seems sort of slightly unreal, doesn't it, that by saying not really. You know, we were involved in all the conversations with at a very senior level with government last year through the electricity generator levy. And so that was something that we were quite pleased to have clarity on. You know, would we have preferred not to have been there? Yeah, we would have preferred that. But ultimately, it probably is important for the country, and it's a good thing for it to have been effectively named, labelled, priced, and moved on. And so we will be paying nearly £200 million over the next 3 years. You know, is that a cloud? Well, not really in some ways. It is out of, you know, good performance. So we're okay with that. And to some extent, if by doing so, you know, the country is, you know, bills are helped by doing that, then that's okay. So that would almost be the only sort of dark cloud. But, you know, we were involved in that all the way through at a senior level with, you know, meetings with prime ministers and chancellors, etc. And so I think that the opinion of the secondary market has been heard, hopefully, alongside, you know, the major utilities that we sit amongst effectively now.
Understood, Stephen. Thank you very much for your candor there and for joining me today on Proactive. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, as always.